In this video, we want to take you through and we want to talk about the Trades tab. Now, this is the Trades tab, and it's probably one of the most important tabs that we have in the software. It's probably the one you'll be working with the most, and so I want to cover it in a little bit of detail. And I'm going to go through and just give you a quick overview of the different features along this, and then we'll talk about some of these other features in greater detail in other videos. But just as an overview, this first tab here, the first window, is a tick-by-tick view of the market as the data comes through. And this goes back to about 200 individual ticks, and you can see that the bid and the ask is identified by green and red. Notice up here we're telling you this is the AUD/USD. The bid is in red, the ask is in green. And then down here, this is the spread information for you, how wide apart those two are. It's red if it's going up, and it's green if it's going down. And because green is better, we want a smaller spread. And then the average, so this is the average spread is 2.5. There it went green, you see it's green, so it's a 2.5, it's at the average. The high, the highest it's been apart is 3.1, and the lowest has been as 1.4. So that's your spread, your spread information. Now this little window here is our accounting window, or what we call our mini accounting window. And we also have down here, and I'm going to put some orders on the screen so we can see a little bit more detail about some of these numbers changing as I get some orders on the screen. But first I want to highlight for you the quantity. This is very simple coming in here, and this is where we change the number of orders that we're going to be placing at any one time. We can do that through this scroll up and scroll down. We can also use the quick buttons just by clicking these buttons, and we can place 15 orders simultaneously or all at the same time, or 5 or 3 or 1, whatever we want to do. And these buttons here are customizable. We can right click on them, hit modify the quantity, and of course you can change that quantity. I've got it set to 1 for my first one. You can set that maybe to 2 if you want it, and then have your scroll be 1. So there's 1, 2, 3, 5, 10, and that's the way we change those numbers there. They're customizable. Now this little BS button here stands for buy and sell. Now we can come in here and we can drag this little buy sell button up on the screen, and you'll notice that when I release the mouse button, it opens up the buy sell order dialog box. Now I'm not going to go into great detail into this right now, we'll do that in another video, but I just wanted to show you the difference between the BS button, which allows you to immediately open up a buy sell order screen and come in and customize the different settings. You can add the OCOs, the limits, the stops, and all that kind of stuff, the trailing stops, through this little dialog box. If you need some additional help, there's an additional help window that you can click that gives you help on what all of these different features mean. So let's come back, and I'm going to close that, and that cancels that order off the screen. It didn't ever place it. And then that's if I want to go through and completely set up a modified order. Now if I just want to do a very quick order, I can come in here and watch this. I can come in and just to place a stop order on the screen, I click stop, drag it on the screen, and you'll notice that if I release the mouse button, that order is placed on the screen and it's active. That's a very active, very quick way of placing an order. So I can do the same thing with limit orders. I can come in here and drag them on the screen. Now notice below the market, a limit order is green. Above the market, it turns red. Same thing with the stop order. You'll notice that the below the market, it's red, and above the market, it's green. And we already placed that stop order on the screen. So we now have 3 orders on the screen, and we're not yet in the market. We have a limit and 2 stops. Now to get into the market very quickly, we can come in here and just hit buy market, and we're in the market long. And that tells us that we can get out of the market very quickly by doing the same thing on the other side. There's sell market, and now we're out of the market. And so that's a very quick way of getting into the market with these quick buttons right here. Now if we wanted to exit all the orders, exit chart is going to take all the orders off the screen. It says this is going to remove all the charts. Are you sure you want to do that? I'm going to say yes. And those are all off the screen. So that's a quick overview of our quick entry buttons. Now I want to just very quickly highlight the quick custom order buttons. Now these buttons down here are customizable. We call them QOCO, and there's QCO, OCO 1, 2, 3, and 4, because we have 4 customizable buttons that are designed to allow you to come in and tell them what you want those buttons to do. Now Q just stands for quick. All right, it's a quick order. Again, when you click on these, it's not going to pull up the dialog box as it did with the BS button. So we can come in here very quickly, and I can say, okay, I want to add an order on here. I can click my QOCO button, and notice that it's placing 3 orders on the screen simultaneously, because that's the way I've programmed it up to do. So I have my stop order above the market with my automatically set in there my limit order and my stop order, and I can do that all with one fell swoop using my QOCO buttons. Now again, I'm not going to go into great detail on these buttons. We'll do that in another video to give you a little bit more detail on how this works. But these buttons are customizable simply by right-clicking on the button and then saying edit or add, and it's going to allow you to open up this dialog box, given the settings, the name, and come through and set them up the way you might want them. And one more thing I want to show you is I want to get an into the market. So let's come in here. I'm going to exit chart and get rid of this. I'm going to add a couple of orders in here. Let's just come in here and let's hit three, and we're going to say buy the market. We're going to buy the market with three contracts. And so we have three contracts in the market, and I want to slide this window up. Now, as I slide it up, you're going to notice that it's going to cover up some of these buttons, but that's okay. Hopefully you have a little bit bigger screen than I do. I'm doing the smaller screen so that it fits into this video recording size. But you'll notice that I have down here, I have four buttons. The first one is the autopilot. And again, I'm not going to touch on the autopilot in this video. That's going to be covered in another video, but I want to talk about pending orders, and I want to talk about open orders, and I want to talk about closed orders. We have in Track and Trade a complete accounting system, so all of your accounting needs are covered right here. You can see all of your pending orders, and we can come in here again with a stop order. We can drop an order in here, and notice it shows up in your pendings orders window. We have open orders, which are also in here. This is our open orders that we have available, and then any closed orders that we've closed out throughout this demonstration. Now, you'll also notice up here, I want to come back and I want to touch very quickly on the accounting window, the little mini accounting tab up here. You'll notice that we have these little blue hyperlinks, and this says chart open P&L dollar sign, so that's why you see a reflection of the dollars. If I click on that, it says percent ROM, so now we have the return on margin, so that changes this dialog over here. And then we come over here and we click it again, and it gives us the pips. Click it again, it takes us back to dollars, and so it kind of rotates through, and I can do that on every single one of these. Notice this one takes you to pips, dollars, return on margin. This one, the realized profit and loss, if I go dollars, I can also do percentage of total or percentage of return on margin or pips and back to dollars. And so we have a lot of control here to give you all the information that you might need to be a wonderful, fantastic trader using Track and Trade.